Well, good morning. This is the day that the Lord has made, and we rejoice and are glad in this day, and we're glad that you're with us in worship this morning. Sandy called yesterday, Sandy Rose, and said she's got the stuff going around, so she had to stay home. Thank you to Cheryl for helping out. So we're going to do piano today. That'll be fun, huh? So appreciate Cheryl very, very much for filling in this morning. This week we have all of our ministries going on, so take advantage of everything that we have. Monday we have council meeting at 6 o'clock, important meeting for council in the upper room at 6. Breakfast club, 9 o'clock in the morning tomorrow, at women's Bible study at 10. Last week, too, we recognized the Boy Scouts, and Dr. Holler did a marvelous job of sharing. And today we're going to recognize Ken Wasman at the second service for all that he does. He's not here with us now, but just to say thank you to him for all that he does for us with the Scouts and also for the youth with all the fundraisers, barbecue, golf tournament, all kinds of things that he does. Valentine's dinner dance, tickets are still on sale. Join with us. That's this Saturday. So we're going to have a lot of fun together. They'll be on sale right after service. Join with us for that fun time together, 5 to 8. It's a fundraiser for our youth, but like I said before, we're giving all the funds away to Puerto Rico for help and disaster relief there. Two other quick announcements. Ronnie and Celeste Thicker celebrated the anniversary, I think, today. And Ed and Ellen Perry, as you see them this morning, they celebrate an anniversary on Friday. We are going to start the story, which you say, well, we've already done the story. But we're going to start just the story about Jesus. We had just great success. It was a lot of fun to do that through the whole Bible in a 36-week series. This is going to be just 7 weeks. It's going to start next Sunday. Even if it's not part of your deal every week to go to Sunday school, we invite you to do that. Join with us for Sunday school right after service. Lots of goodies to have, but most importantly, some great material to look at 7 weeks through Lent for Sunday school starting next week. Just take a look at this.
This is your story.
This is your story.
This is your story.
This is my story.
This is my story.
This is my story.
But most of all,
this is the greatest story ever told.
This is God's story.
This is God's story.
This is God's story.
All of history changed when God became flesh, entered the world, and walked on our earth. Ever since Jesus has been on this earth, history has been different. God is in our house. We know that, and we can hear his voice, and we can sense his presence. And thanks to the teachings of the New Testament, we have access to the great promises of God as spoken and revealed through Jesus Christ. We see them in his teaching. We see them in his death, burial, and resurrection. We see his promises in the great coming of the Holy Spirit that changes the lives of those who give their hearts to God.
I know you're really going to enjoy and appreciate this wonderful experience as you fully explore how we all fit into the greatest story ever told, God's story.
So join us starting next Sunday if you can. Also, real quick, we are trying something new today, thanks to Tony and his help, but we're going to be doing everything on PowerPoint, so you hardly need your bulletin. So we're hoping this will be just a transition for us as a church family. I'm going to invite you to stand now as we share together in the hymn.
Thank you. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
God of all mercy and consolation, come to the help of your people, turning us from our sin to live for you alone. Give us the power of your Holy Spirit that we may confess our sin, receive your forgiveness, and grow into the fullness of Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord.
Amen.
Let us confess our sin in the presence of God and one another. Most merciful God, we confess that we are captive to sin and cannot free ourselves. We have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us. Forgive us, renew us, and lead us, so that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways to the glory of your holy name. Amen. In the mercy of Almighty God, Jesus Christ was given to die for us. And for his sake, God forgives us all our sins. As a called and ordained minister of the Church of Christ and in Christ's authority, I therefore declare to you the entire forgiveness of all of your sins in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Let us pray. Lord God, with endless mercy, you receive the prayers of all who call upon you. By your Spirit, show us the things we ought to do, and give us the grace and power to do them. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen.
seated.
Good morning. The second reading comes from 1 Corinthians, the second chapter, beginning with the first verse. When I came to you, brothers and sisters, I did not come proclaiming the mystery of God to you in lofty words or wisdom, for I decided to know nothing among you except Jesus Christ and Him crucified. And I came to you in weakness and in fear and in much trembling. My speech and my proclamation were not with plausible words of wisdom, but with a demonstration of the Spirit and of power, so that your faith might rest not on human wisdom, but on the power of God. Yet among the mature, we do speak wisdom, though it is not a wisdom of this age or the rulers of this age, who are doomed to perish. But we speak God's wisdom, secret and hidden, which God decreed before the ages for our glory. None of the rulers of this age understood this, for if they had, they would not have crucified the Lord of glory. But as it is written, what no eye has seen, nor ear heard, nor the human heart conceived, what God has prepared for those who love Him, these things God has revealed to us through the Spirit. For the Spirit searches everything, even the depths of God. For what human being knows what is truly human except the human spirit that is within? So also no one comprehends what is truly God's except the Spirit of God. Now we have received not the spirit of the world, but the Spirit that is from God, so that we may understand the gifts bestowed upon us by God. And we speak of these things in words not taught by human wisdom, but taught by the Spirit, interpreting spiritual things to those who are spiritual. Those who are unspiritual do not receive the gifts of God's Spirit, for they are foolishness to them, and they are unable to understand them because they are spiritually discerned. Those who are spiritual discern all things, and they are themselves subject to no one else's scrutiny. For who has known the mind of the Lord so as to instruct Him? But we have the mind of Christ. Please stand for the scripture.
At this time for the children's sermon. Here, Claire. Come on. How's everybody doing? Good? Did you enjoy that snow the other day? Wasn't that fun? It's fun to see it coming down. Come on, Savannah. All right, Eddie. It was really neat to see it, wasn't it? We may get more tomorrow. What do you think about that, huh? It'd be okay if it's stuck on the ground, wouldn't it? It'd be all right? Yeah. Jayla says, oh, yeah. All right. Well, we have a pretty important day coming up. On Friday. Does anybody know what it is? Good for you, Valentine's Day. And this is the kind of stuff that happens on Valentine's Day. What's this in the shape of?
A heart.
And what is a heart? What does that mean generally? Means love. Yeah, exactly. Exactly. And today, Jesus talks about love, but He talks about it in a little different way. He says that we are to be like, what's in here? Salt. Okay. And that we're to be like light. Well, good. You didn't say flashlight. Good. All right. Yeah. Not like a flashlight, but to be like light and like salt. Now, how can we be like light and like salt? Isn't that interesting? Let's unpack that just a minute. See what He's saying, okay? Because He wants us to use these two things, salt and light, to change the world around us. And we do that with love, the love that He's first given us, okay? Salt is kind of neat, isn't it? Now, what do you like to put salt on? Eddie, yes. Huh? Nothing? Well, how about, do you like popcorn? Popcorn has to have butter and it has to have salt, doesn't it? I mean, you have to go all in. When you're watching a movie or something, if you're going to have that stuff, yeah, exactly. And it helps season different things like meat and everything else. Salt's used a lot, even when we don't know it, in cooking and stuff. Now, I know when I was your age, I had a flashlight like this, a little one like this, but more importantly, I had a nightlight in my room. You don't have to tell me if you do, but I loved having a nightlight because it gave me just enough light. I could see my way out of the bedroom to the bathroom if I needed to, and it kind of just, it can be kind of scary to be in the dark, can't it? And light really is really cool because it gives, takes away the fear. We can see what's going around that way. Isn't that true? So you think about that with God, and we're supposed to be like salt. We're supposed to change the environment around us, okay? And we're supposed to be like light. Darkness comes in all kinds of different ways. It doesn't just mean like a night sky. But darkness, sometimes people can feel down, can't they? They can feel kind of dark in their lives. So Jesus is saying, share his love that he has first given us with other people and help change the world. He says, be salt and be light. Isn't that fun? All right, you think about that this week, okay? And especially on Friday, Valentine's Day, think of anything you can do special. Maybe it's somebody in school or your parents or a brother and sister. Some way you can let them know that you love them, okay? All right, let's pray. Lord, we just thank you for this time together. And Father, we thank you for these little ones who touch and change our lives just by their presence with us. Lord, you call us to be salt and light. Help us to be agents of change in this world that needs it so desperately. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. All right, y'all. Help yourselves. Nobody wants any salt, huh? Claire, get some, huh? There you go. We're going to do the gospel reading just a little bit differently. You can remain seated. I want you to picture a green hillside. Jesus is at the top of the hill, and he's speaking to his disciples, a motley crew, as we know, tax collectors and farmers and fishermen, zealots, and anybody else who wants to listen. And Jesus says to all of them, he says, you are the light of the world. Can you imagine how they took that? Probably looked at each other like, oh my goodness, the light of the world? I am the world? Oh my gosh, I can't even be light for myself some days, let alone my family or my community. The world? And Jesus says the same thing to us. You and I, we are the light of the world. It seems absolutely overwhelming at first blush when you think about it. I mean, because I'm stumbling around in the dark in my own life so much and having a hard time finding direction oftentimes. How can I be light to the world? I love Charlie Brown comics. And there's one in particular that I love. Lucy has given her 5 cents worth, you know, her counseling. She's sitting at her desk like she does like this. Charlie Brown comes up and Lucy says to Charlie Brown, Charlie Brown, life is like a cruise ship and everybody has their own deck chair. Some people have a deck chair that's in the back of the ship and they're looking at what's gone on in the past. And others have a deck chair they put up in the front of the ship and they're looking at what's coming up. Charlie Brown, where is your deck chair? To which a rather befuddled Charlie Brown says, Lucy, I can't even get my deck chair open right now. That's probably how we feel a lot. You know what I mean? Light to the world? Really? This conversation really happened the other day at our house. Laura said to me, honey, I'm so frustrated. I can't find my cell phone. To which I responded, I will help you in just a minute. We can call your cell phone if you help me find where mine is. How can we be light if we can't even find our own direction? Maybe Jesus is saying this instead, and that is this, that we don't have to point to ourselves because I don't have it all together. You don't have it all together. But he does, Jesus Christ, have it all together. So we point to him as the true source of light. Interesting thing, he uses both salt and light. And salt and light, like I shared with the kids, do some interesting things, really. Salt and light change everything. They change the environment. They change the atmosphere that they're in. You only need to go to the ocean for a little while to see what salt can do to absolutely everything. And try to eat pretzels or potato chips without salt sometime. We try to do that to be healthy. And it doesn't work. You know what I mean? It's not very good. Salt changes everything. And light changes everything. If we just darken this entire room, one little tiny candle, one little light would change everything. Salt and light, Jesus is saying, change the atmosphere. Change the environment that you are in. And there's another thing when it comes to salt and light, and that is, something has to happen to make them respond, to make them open up. If you take a salt shaker, even though you have salt in here, it's absolutely worthless until somebody opens it up and pours out the salt. And when it comes to light, light is really not light until you turn on the switch, flip the switch, and let the light shine. Something has to happen. Change has to happen. We have to use these gifts that God has given us. And you think about our Lord. He could have just talked about how much he loves us. But instead, the Word took on flesh and dwelt among us. He left the safety and the sanctuary of the light of heavenly glory to come down in the midst of our darkness to make a difference for us. We have to move. We have to make a change. Salt has to come out of the shaker. Light has to be turned on. In Gatlinburg, we had a speaker there that shared this analogy. I wish I could say it was mine, but I will never forget this. You know, motion detector lights? Everybody has one of those probably at home. And that thing is a light. Like you said, it's surely a light, but it's never going to come on, what, until somebody moves in front of it. It says, so it is with the light of Christ. We have to take one step, a little bit of motion, a little bit of movement. Something has to happen. And then all of a sudden the light is shared. And lives are changed and touched. Something as simple as a pillowcase. made into a dress. Can you imagine when the little ones, the girls get these dresses? Their faces are going to literally light up. We have prayer stoles that some other folks are making for six folks who are battling cancer right now. Can you imagine giving those to them and saying that these have been prayed over for you? What is God calling you to do to be the light, to be the salt? Maybe it's a call. Maybe it's a card. Maybe it's reaching out to somebody you haven't seen for a long time. Maybe it's just praying or opening up His love letter. Whatever it is, God calls us to do that. Billy Johnson shared with me the other day that he's been talking to Dennis Parlier. And it took me a little while to understand what was going on exactly, but Dennis is pretty much training Billy how to make those crosses that he's made all these years. Dennis has been making these crosses for some 17 years, and I don't mean hundreds. I mean thousands of crosses. Can you imagine over this period of time how many lives have been touched by having one of those? How many people in surgery before we have a prayer and they grab a hold of that cross and they hold on tight? Dennis is having some struggles physically and mentally right now, and we lift up he and Peggy in our prayers. There's a good possibility he won't be making those crosses anymore. And you know how moving it was to hear that Billy is taking that step forward, that next step to keep this legacy of love going on. Be the light and the salt of the world. There was a college in Baltimore in which the sociology professor invited his students in sociology to go out into the inner city, and they were to talk to 200 young people there that were in very difficult, challenging circumstances, and then to come back and report what they found out. And what they found out to a person, every single one of them said that their chances of success and doing anything meaningful in life because of their circumstances was probably quite minimal. Somebody, another professor, 25 years later, got a hold of this report and had his class go out to these same kids that they were kids at the time. Now they're 25 years older, and find out about their lives. What was going on? Of the 200, 20 had either moved or had died. There were 176, though, of the 200 that they interviewed. And they found amazing results. All kinds of success. All kinds of positive, good decisions that they made in their lives. They were doctors. They were lawyers. They were politicians. They were preachers. They were teachers. They were good people who took advantage of the gifts that God had given them. And they were absolutely surprised when they interviewed them because of their circumstances. And then they asked one question: what is it? What would you attribute this to? And to a person, every single one of them said, it was my teacher. So you can imagine this professor wanted to find this teacher. She happened to still be alive. And when they found this teacher, she was alert as anything and just full of enthusiasm and all. And the professor said to her, ma'am, if you don't mind, tell me, what was your magical formula? What did you do for these guys to get them so motivated and inspired to use all the gifts that they have? And her eyes just twinkled, and she had a smile on her face, and she said, oh, she said, I just love those boys. I just love them. On the hillside, 2,000 years ago, our teacher, our rabbi, Jesus, looked out at the disciples with love. And he said, you can change the world. You can be salt, and you can be light to the world if you share the love that you have first been given. See what love the Father has given us, as John says, that we should be called children of God, and so we are. And Matthew remembered our Lord saying those great words that we share in the baptismal service: let your light so shine before others that they see your good works and give glory to your Father who is in heaven. Be salt, be light, change our world together. Amen. Please stand. Our faith in the words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Thank you. this morning, we invite you to come forward and kneel as you're able. And we'll come down the center aisle, just follow the usher's lead, and fill in the back all the way around to kneel. And then we'll have a table blessing at each communion time together.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
On the night in which our Lord was betrayed, he took bread, gave thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." Again, after supper, he took the cup and gave thanks and gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant of my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this in remembrance of me." Gathered into one by the power of the Holy Spirit, let us pray as our Lord taught us. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever.
The gifts of God for the people of God. Come, for the table is ready.
In the darkest hour, when I cannot breathe, fear is on my chest, the weight of the world on me. Everything's crashing down, everything I have known. When I wonder if I'm all alone, I remember.
Salt and his go and be his salt and his light in the world.
May the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ strengthen you and keep you in his grace.
Amen.
Let us pray. We give you thanks, Almighty God, that you have refreshed us through the healing power of this gift of life. In your mercy, strengthen us through this gift in faith toward you and in fervent love toward one another. For the sake of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
Now may the Lord bless us and keep us. May the Lord make his face shine upon us and be gracious unto us. May the Lord look upon us with favor and give us his peace. Amen.
Amen.
Peace, serve the Lord. Thanks be to God.